The channel growers are still comfortable with using it, and they have every right to the registered chemical. And at this point, the ACBMA legislators are comfortable with its use in Australia. So, you know, I suppose you need to pose the question to them why it's still available for use in agriculture if it's been banned in those countries overseas. I'd like to point out that some of the issues that we've been proactive. When the moratorium was placed on a chemical called sherbene, a fungicide that we used to use in the sugar industry, that moratorium was placed on it and there was a phase-out period attached to that. The sugar industry mandated an early phase-out action by our members, and we phased out 3 years ahead of what was required by the authorities. So when we're asked to move or adjust our practices, we do so. We're a responsible industry, and I just feel it was very irresponsible of the researchers to find a spike and then throw out this alarmism now when it's 4 years down the track and expecting us to find answers.
And what is it that the cane industry does to prevent the runoff of chemicals into the water?
Well, a lot of our practices have changed. We encourage water transfer into our drains. We have vegetated sides on our drains. You know, the use of mandra vegetation along the edges for silt traps. We have mown headlands and mown trackways rather than just bare gravel and bare dirt. So we use them as silt traps. And again, we're using these chemicals as they're designed by accredited operators under the correct conditions of winds and humidity and all that sort of stuff. So that's proven up by the 2021 results where there was no sites that were out of bounds or over the limits, if you like. There were traces there, but you're talking about in the millions of a gram per litre of water. But it is so tiny, almost undetectable, and way under the allowable limits.
Okay, well, we'll have to leave it there. Thank you so much for your time this morning, Ross Farlow. Really appreciate it.
Thanks, Kim.
That is Ross Farlow, the chairman of New South Wales Cane Growers. It is 26 past 6. Well, 3 weeks after fire ants were detected at South Moorumba, another confirmed infestation of concern to farmers in the Tweed Valley. A fire ant nest has been detected in the Currumbin Valley, just over the border, outside the biosecurity zone. On the New South Wales side, Jan Fletcher's property at Higgabeen, where she runs Hereford cattle, runs 3 kilometres along the border.
Yes, it's actually very scary. Hoping against hope that it wouldn't happen, but with the recently we've had prevailing winds predominantly from the north, it's to be expected, unfortunately.
And how concerned are you about it?
Well, very concerned because the queen is reported down flight about 5 kilometres. They seem to be making a natural progression south. We heard about the Calabudra and now they're at Currumbin, and where next, aren't we? I think it's a really serious biosecurity threat there. The nasty little beast is concern for everybody. Our family works this place. We've got children and grandchildren working with us. The wildlife, if you read the details, the wildlife can be impacted on it, on the environmental impact. It's a huge worry, yes.
And so you are easily within 5 kilometres of where that nest has been found?
Definitely. We can't hide from that way, I don't think.
Have you been checking your property for fire ants at all? How accessible is your property to check?
Wherever we go, and we've been spraying for hummingbirds like that as a preferred habitat, but they like sunny areas. And we've put fire trails here, we've done our track, and they provide sunny areas, so it looks like we're going to have to be a lot more vigilant and drive our tracks and look and see. It's a huge worry.
So they could well be there and you don't know about it just yet?
Yes, that sounds good.
Now you breed Hereford cattle on your property there?
Yes, we have beautiful Herefords.
And are you worried about what kind of impact if fire ants did, you know, make their way to your property and then you did find an infestation? Are you worried about the impact, the possible impact on your cattle, you know, as well as your family?
It has to be, because they say that they smother them. The calves can be smothered by fire ants, because calves are very curious creatures and they'll put their nose down and check out something that's different or new. That's why they tend to get bitten by snakes more than the cows do. And they're very curious creatures, and they say that the fire ants can none of them. I don't know enough about it. I'll have to do a lot more research.
Jen Fletcher from Pickabeen, and to the Lismore Cattle Markets, 900 head yard of Kevin Cocciola.
The market in general has followed the markets all around New South Wales this week, just to be a shade cheaper for all classes of cattle. The best for cows this week topped 223 cents a kilo, with most of these better cows in the 190 to 215 cent bracket. The second run of cows range from 142 to 175 cents, and the plainer cows 80 cents up to 142 cents a kilo. Bulls this week topped at 223 cents a kilo, with the younger bulls up to 252 cents. In the veal section, calves this week, the steer calves made a top of 338 cents for the better end of them, for the quality and the condition that was on them. Most of these calves range from the 320 cent through to 330 cent brackets. The second run of steer calves range from 250 cents through to 280 cents a kilo.
Thanks, Kevin. And that is it for the Rural Report today. Country Hour from noon, news time, and 6:30. Eloise Farrow-Smith with ABC North Coast News. Tributes are flowing for a Gold Coast pilot and his son killed in a light plane crash in northern New South Wales earlier this week. Lane Cookshorn and his son died after their plane flew into power lines before crashing onto the riverbank of the Clarence River at Lilydale on Tuesday morning. Southport Flying Club manager Steve Rance says Mr. Cookshorn had been a member of the club for more than a decade and was a family man and keen aviator.
Very shaken by it. We had to hear of anybody getting killed in an aircraft accident with one of our members. It's pretty hard. So we had a long, big future ahead of
us. A New South Wales woman who was jailed for decades over the deaths of four of her children and then pardoned is expected to find out if her convictions will be quashed today. Penny Timms reports.
In 2003, Kathleen Folbig was found guilty of the murder of three of her children and the manslaughter of a fourth. They died between the years of 1989 and 1999. Folbig has always maintained her innocence. The case lacked physical evidence, so it was largely built on circumstance. But after several appeals and inquiries, new scientific evidence emerged, suggesting there was reasonable doubt on this report. This year, Kathleen Folbig was pardoned by the state of New South Wales and immediately released from prison, where she served 20 years. The matter would then referred to the Court of Criminal Appeal, which will decide if her original convictions should be overturned.
Police are investigating a report a woman was assaulted by a man impersonating a police officer at Moolumbah. Emma Rennie reports.
Police say the woman was driving along Timbolgan Road on Sunday night when a white sedan with a blue flashing light started following her. After she pulled over, the man told the woman to get out of the vehicle and sexually touched her. Police are looking to question a man with a medium build and Caucasian appearance, aged between 35 and 45, with dark hair cut short on the sides. Police also believe several cars drove past during the incident and urge any witnesses to come forward. Anyone with concerns about being stopped can contact their nearest police station or request official ID from officers.
The latest crime statistics reveal startling trends in regional New South Wales on domestic and sexual assault. The New South Wales Bureau of Crime Statistics relates to crimes over the past 5 years up to September this year. Bureau Acting Executive Director Susan Poynton says most major crime categories are trending downwards or are stable, particularly property crime. But Ms. Poynton says there's a significant increase in regional New South Wales for domestic assault.
Where we're seeing the biggest increases is Coffs Harbour, Grafton area. That's increased by 72% in terms of the number of domestic violence-related assaults in the last 5 years. But we're also seeing big increases in the North Coast, a 48% increase.
A biosecurity zone will straddle the New South Wales-Queensland border after a new nest of fire ants was uncovered yesterday in the Currumbin Valley. The Invasive Species Council says the infestation was found by biosecurity officers on a rural residential property less than a kilometre north of the New South Wales border. Advocacy manager Rhys Panata says the problem isn't going away.
The 5 kilometre biosecurity zone will stretch into northern New South Wales, but we think that that should be increased beyond that, probably as far south as Ballumbar, given that northern New South Wales is now firmly in the crosshairs of fire ants.
Byron Shire Council will today consider whether to move ahead with a controversial subdivision at Brunswick Heads, from what Herbert reports.
Plans for the 130-lot development were put on hold in October while environmental reports were referred for independent assessment. The concept plan for the project was approved 10 years ago, and the most recent plans approved by the regional planning panel in May this year. The latest recommendation from council staff is to note the reports and go ahead with issuing the subdivision works certificate for ecological rehabilitation. Councillor Duncan Day says he intends to move a motion to defer consideration of the matter, saying there's not enough information on the Wollum froglet.
A local think tank is turning its attention to look at how land left vacant after the buyback scheme can be used for the community in Lismore. The Living Lab's Dan Etheridge says community discussions will take place and a focus area will be looking at what to do with the checkerboard of land left vacant. You've been listening to local ABC News.
This is Bridey Tanner on ABC North Coast.
Good morning, 25 minutes to 7 on your Thursday, the 14th of December.
On the first day of Christmas, my true love sent to me.
Question, is the 12 days of Christmas, the 12 days leading up to Christmas, that is...
child.
Last name is, or method.
much longer than 5 minutes.
Thank you.
wolf?
It's a dog and a rooster.
Time for your quiz question this morning. And it's a where am I for your Thursday? The beach connecting Snapper Rocks to Point Danger shows a painted picture of what creature on the rocks? The beach connecting Snapper Rocks to Point Danger shows a painted picture of what animal on the rocks? 1-300-65-9994. What creature is painted on the rocks between Snapper Rocks and Point Danger? 1-300-65-9994 if you'd like to solve our quiz question. And a hot day for the northern rivers today, partly cloudy, slight chance of a shower, and the chance of a thunderstorm coming this afternoon. Winds north to northwesterly, getting up to 25 kilometres an hour. And daytime maximum temperatures in the mid to high 30s. Watch out, could get warm. Tony Matthews with ABC News. Israel says it won't bow to international pressure over ending the war in Gaza. More from Middle East correspondent Alison Horn in Jerusalem.
Israel's foreign minister says a ceasefire now would be a gift to Hamas and will allow it to return and threaten Israeli residents, adding the war will continue with or without international support. It follows a resolution demanding a ceasefire in Gaza that received overwhelming international support at the United Nations General Assembly, including backing from Australia for the first time. The Gaza Ministry of Health says the Palestinian death toll in Gaza has now risen to more than 18,600 people.
Cyclone Jasper has weakened overnight after crossing the far north Queensland coast late yesterday. It's now a tropical low and is now struggling with it.
Lost power. Trees were knocked down and there's been some property damage. The full extent will become clearer after an assessment this morning. New South Wales paramedics say they've finally been given professional recognition with the Minns government offering them a historic pay rise to prevent a mass walkout and exodus to better paying states. But the opposition leader has criticised the deal, as Jean Kennedy reports.
After a long fight by the Health Services Union, paramedics have won an average 25% pay rise over 4 years, with senior critical care paramedics receiving as much as 29%. Union boss Jared Hayes.
They are financially and professionally recognised, and so they are equal to doctors, nurses and everybody else.
Opposition leader Mark Speakman.
We shouldn't be robbing our health system to give pay increases to paramedics.
The Treasurer Daniel Mookie concedes it could pave the way for similar wage claims from other unions. And while he says he'll work with them too, he argues paramedics have a special case.
A new report from the National Rural Health Alliance has revealed rural Australians are battling significant health inequity compared to people living in major cities. Lexi Jewellick explains.
According to the Rural Health in Australia snapshot for 2023, the further an Australian lives from an urban centre, the lower their life expectancy. Small rural towns of less than 5,000 people have access to almost 60% fewer health professionals than major cities per capita. The report shows major cities have more choice and more GPs, while many rural people have no access to primary healthcare services within an hour's drive from their home. The Alliance's Chief Executive Susie Teagan
Hey? Yeah, but I really love the curry.
Hey?
I don't really hate them, you know that.
Hospital in extra, rather than having to admit it because of heat wave from dehydration, this is the first time that the
one.
Okay, can Vlad all prevail?
Depends on what the plan is. Breaks down, you got Aaron and her mate right side, you got the top level top up.
we say it's
you
not.
You just stay, it's on holiday. You just stay on holiday, okay?
hey, you know what? People who say, hey, it's not all about you, they're just trying to make it all about them. That's what I'm going to say.
Many times.
And what do you do then? It
should be.
Nice.
To listen to the news. Yeah. And,
right. So, where Miles you would like?
This evening. Also, we've sadly heard from some people paying tribute to the pilot and his son who were killed when their plane crashed at Lilydale earlier this week. And we're going to hear about a police impersonator. Some information about someone who allegedly pulled over a woman and impersonating a police officer. So some details about that.
It's a bit creepy.
Fire ants making their march. They've been detected like less than a kilometre north of the New South Wales border.
Well, here we are, love.
As well as, yeah.
You have a wonderful time with Marzi.
Yeah, he's back. Have a wonderful time with him too. Are you dreading it?
No, not at all.
Because you're peace and quiet, may not be peace and quiet.
I guess we'll see, won't we?
I'll tell him that he has to be very good. I'll bribe him. And when Miles is doing, give him a choice. Well, you do. You give him a choice between two things, but don't give him an open choice. Like, do you want the ice cream or no ice cream ever for a week? You know.
Oh, this is bullshit.
When Christmas is near.
Kevin. The undies. The trundies.
Bye.